अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द सीरीज ऑन हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क इन मैटलैब सिमुलिंक सॉफ्टवेयर। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट ANN इन मैटलैब। इन मैटलैब आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क कैन बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड बाई वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वेज। नंबर वन, ANN कैन बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड थ्रू मैटलैब प्रोग्राम। Number 2, ANN can be implemented by using the Simulink. Number 3, ANN can be implemented by using the GUI tool. Let's start from the first method. Friends, before going to start, I would like to request all of you that for better understanding, you must start practicing with me step by step. By doing this way, it will be easy for all of you to understand and implement ANN training in MATLAB. In order to teach you the ANN implementation through MATLAB program, I am going to consider a mathematical example. Let's take an example of a model having the three inputs A, B and C, which generates an output Y. Suppose the model has the following mathematical equation consisting of Y is equal to 2A plus 3B plus 5C. Now the output Y can be obtained by putting the input values of A, B and C. At this stage, I want to highlight the advantage of artificial neural network that ANN does not requires the mathematical equation for its learning. In fact, ANN requires input and output data only. Based upon this data, the ANN goes into training process for its learning and understanding the relationship between the input and output data. Once the training is successfully completed, the ANN can provide the accurate output for any input variable without knowing the mathematical equation. Therefore, at first stage, we need the data for the ANN. It is the first primary requirement of the ANN implementation. Now I am going to discuss the ways by which data can be obtained for the ANN implementation. Number one, the data can be collected from the industries or government organizations such as WABDA, NTDC and PEPCO or any other national or international organization depending upon the type of the model to be considered for the ANN. Number 2, the data can be collected by doing the experiments. Number 3, the data can be collected by doing the simulation in any software. Now let's collect the data for this mathematical equation. Suppose we need the 1000 output data with following ranges of the inputs. It means that minimum and maximum range of the input A, B and C are taken from 0 to 1. To get the 1000 data samples, we are going to use the random function of the MATLAB which generates different number of samples within the range. Let me teach you this random function first. For this purpose, just look at the MATLAB syntax of the random function, where x shows the number of rows and y shows the number of columns, and rand by default generates the random numbers from 0 to 1. Now suppose if we want to produce 5 samples within the range 0 to 1, then the syntax will become as below. Let me show you this in the MATLAB. Just write this code on the command window and press enter. You can see MATLAB has generated 5 random numbers within the range of 0 and 1. Now suppose we want to increase the range from 0 to 5 and sample up to 10, then following changes will be required as shown in the format. It may be noted that 5 is multiplied in order to increase its range from 0 to 5, whereas 10 is written to get the total number of samples. Let me show you this in the MATLAB again. Just write this code on the command window and press enter. You can see MATLAB has generated 10 random numbers having range within 0 and 5. Now suppose if we want to generate 10 random numbers from 10 to 15 range. To write such random numbers, MATLAB has the following syntax, where A shows the maximum range and B shows the minimum range. Therefore, to get 10 random numbers from 10 to 15, following changes will be required as shown in the format. Let me show you this in the MATLAB again. Just write this code on the command window and press enter. You can see MATLAB has generated 10 random numbers within the range of 10 and 15. Friends, I hope now you are clear how different random numbers can be generated for different input ranges. Let's come back to our mathematical example, in which we are required to get 1000 samples of the inputs for the range from 0 to 1 and its output. Therefore, for better results, we are going to write this code in the new M file. To write this code, first click on this button, a new M file will be opened. First, save it with any name and in any folder. Now, write the whole code as it is. Now, run this program by clicking on this button. You can see MATLAB has generated 1000 samples for input A, B, C as well as 1000 samples for the output. Let me show you the whole data. Just look at the workspace section. You can see the MATLAB has created 4 variables, namely A, B, C and Y. Just look at this side, it shows that each variable has 1000 samples. As we know that ANN requires only the input and output data. Therefore, we need to combine all the inputs into single input data. For this purpose, we can introduce an array and combine all these inputs. To get this, just add the following lines in the code. It may be noted that the variable I represents the input data and T represents the target data or output data. Furthermore, we have intentionally put the semicolon after each variable. This is necessary because we want to put all the variables in the form of columns. Let me show you this by clicking on this run button. Now just click on the I variable to see its values. You can see the input variable I consists of 3 rows having 1000 samples in each row. Friends, our first stage of the ANN implementation is completed, because we have collected all the input and output data for the ANN training. Now just click on this plus button to open another new M file. Now write here the input and output data variables as shown here. Now this is the time to write the code to initialize the artificial neural network. In order to save the time, I have already saved this code, therefore I am just pasting it here. Friends, don't be confused with this code. It is very easy. An interesting point is that this code remains almost same for any type of the problem. Therefore, for your convenience, I have shared the link in the description section. You may download this code from there. Now I am going to explain this code step by step. Just look at this line of the code. In this line, the word NET shows the artificial neural network. And new FF means new feed forward neural network is going to be introduced. Min max of I is written to include the minimum and maximum value of the total input data in order to know the minimum and maximum input range for the training. Now 3, 5 and 1 represents basically the number of neurons in the input layer, hidden layer and output layer. As we have 3 input variables, namely A, B, C, therefore we have chosen 3 neurons for the input layer. Similarly, we have 1 output, namely Y, therefore we have used 1 neuron in the output layer. Now question arises, how many neurons we may choose for hidden layer? The answer to this question is that there is no such rule for choosing the number of neurons. Therefore, we may start from 5 neurons to get the training. If the training is succeed, then good. Otherwise, we may increase the number of neurons and train the neural network again and again until the training is successfully completed. Let's move ahead. The term logsig, tensig and purelin are the activation functions for the input, hidden and output layer respectively. These activation functions are also used arbitrarily, and we may use any activation function depending upon the need of the problem. However, usually all these three most common activation functions are used at the first stage of the training. Mostly, ANN completes its training successfully with these activation functions. However, in case the ANN failed to train correctly, then we may change the activation functions to get the successful training of the ANN. It may be noted that PureLin represents the pure linear activation function. This function is commonly used in the output layer. Last segment represents the training algorithm. MATLAB has many training algorithms already developed and stored in it. Let me share with you the list of various algorithms. These all are the algorithms that can be used for the ANN training. I have highlighted the most common algorithms that are used for the ANN training, which provides the good results. However, among all these training algorithms, Liebenberg-Marquardt backpropagation algorithm is most widely used for ANN training. It is because this algorithm provides fast results for most of the cases. That's why ANN always uses this algorithm by default for its training. You can see here Liebenberg-Marquardt training algorithm MATLAB code is written as TrainLM. Now this code line indicates that artificial neural network is initialized by these input-output data and these layers. This code line is used to show the training error at each iteration. This code line is used to represent the number of iterations. You may choose any number of iterations depending upon the complexity of the problem. However, by default, I have chosen 1000 iterations. It may be noted that the word epochs simply means iteration. The second last line represents the threshold limit or convergence limit. In iterative process, we usually put the limit up to 4 decimal, up to 6 decimal or still higher. By default, the stopping criteria is set 10 raised to power minus 12. The last line is written to perform the ANN training based upon the input and output data. It may be noted that the word net here represents the ANN network. The letter I represents the name of the input data, whereas T represents the name of the output or target data. Friends, I want to repeat the same point which I already have mentioned in the start of the video, that ANN does not require the mathematical equation for its learning. ANN requires only the input and output data. And from this data, ANN learns the behavior and relationship between the input and output variables. It may be noted again that we know the mathematical equation, but ANN does not know the equation. However, despite of not knowing the exact equation, ANN from its training can find the relationship between the input and output data. This is the main advantage of the ANN. Due to this advantage, ANN can be used for any complex power system or any engineering problem whose mathematical equation is not known. I will prove it during the testing of the ANN. Friends, at this stage, our program for ANN training is completed. Now to start the training, we have to click on this button. First, save it with any name and in any folder. You can see as I click on this run button, after few seconds, new GUI window is opened and ANN training is started. It will take some time to complete the training. In our case, the ANN training is completed very fast. Friends, at this stage, I want to highlight again another important point, that when you start training the ANN on your own computer or laptop, the ANN may give different results due to the fact that it depends upon the CPU speed, RAM size, MATLAB version, etc. Now let's see the training is successful or not. Just look at the neural network training figure. At the top, it shows that the ANN consists of three layers, namely input, hidden, and output layer. Where input layer has three neurons, hidden layer has five neurons, and output layer has one neuron as shown here. Now look at this section, it represents the name of the training algorithm. As we have already chosen the Liebenberg-Marquardt training algorithm, therefore its name is written here as TrainLM. Furthermore, its performance check is done by mean squared error known as MSE. Now look at this section known as process section. In this section, the first line shows the epochs, which simply means iteration. You can see our training is completed at 395th iteration. That's why ANN has stopped its training. The second line shows the total time taken by the ANN for its training. Luckily for this problem, it has taken extremely small time. Otherwise, depending upon the complexity of the problem, it may take even several days to complete its training. The third point represents the performance. It may be noted that our stopping criteria or accuracy was set up to 10^-12, which was successfully reached at 395th iteration. Friends, in this example, luckily ANN has given ideal performance in which it achieves the goal of 10^-12 at 395th iteration. However, most of the times ANN takes lot of time to achieve this goal. Therefore, if your results are different, then no need to worry about it. It is because the important criteria for the successful ANN training is the regression curve. If the regression is equal to 1, then its training is successful. Otherwise, it need to be trained again. Let me show you this in the plot section as shown here. It may be noted that among all plots, the last regression plot is very important for checking the successful training of the ANN. Therefore, click on this regression. You will see a new window is opened showing the regression curve for the ANN training. This curve provides very useful information about the ANN training and shows that the maximum output from the given input data is 10, as shown on the horizontal axis. Just look at the equation again and put the maximum values of input A, B and C as 1 and calculate the output. You will see that the total output is 10. You can see ANN, without knowing this mathematical equation, has exactly understood the relationship between the input and output data. Furthermore, you must notice that here regression R is equal to 1. It means that ANN has successfully trained up to 100%. It is because 1 here represents the 100%. I told you earlier that luckily in this problem everything looks ideal. However, in most of the real problems, this regression does not come to unity. Then what is the limit to know whether the ANN has successfully trained or not? The answer to this question is that we must try to train the ANN and get the regression up to 1 as close as possible. However, if due to any reason it is not achieved, then at least regression must be greater than 0.9. It is because a regression greater than 0.9 will most probably provide the satisfactory results in the testing. However, this is the last point. Otherwise, there are many ways by which ANN can be trained to obtain the regression up to 1. I will discuss all these ways later on in this ANN series, maybe in the next part of this series. Now look at the blue line, which shows the ideal output or fit line. It means that after successful training, all the data points must lie on this line. You can see in this case, all the data points shown in the form of circles are lying on this blue line, which again shows that the ANN has successfully trained. If ANN training is not successful due to any reason, then these circles will not lie on this blue line, but some circles may lie on the top or bottom space of the line. Last, look at the vertical line. It represents the output as calculated by ANN will have the following value. Now look at the plot of the performance curve by clicking on the performance. A new window will open. It shows plot between mean squared error versus iterations. It shows that the best training performance is 9.986 × 10^-13 at the 395th iteration. Friends, at this stage, our training is successfully completed. Now look at this workspace window. You can see now a new variable, namely NAT, is available. This NAT is our trained artificial neural network. Therefore, now we have to save this trained ANN in the folder anywhere you want. I am saving it in drive D and folder ANN so that I may recall it whenever I need it. फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू डोंट सेव दिस ट्रेंड ANN, देन नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन यू ओपन द मैटलैब यू हैव टू स्टार्ट द ANN ट्रेनिंग अगेन फ्रॉम द जीरो. देयरफॉर इट मस्ट बी सेव्ड इन एनी फोल्डर. नाउ लेट्स टेस्ट द ANN फॉर वेरियस इनपुट्स इन ऑर्डर टू टेस्ट इट्स परफॉर्मेंस. फॉर दिस पर्पज वी हैव टू राइट एन अदर कोड लाइन फॉर द टेस्टिंग एज शोन हेयर. We can write this code line in the M file as well as in the command window. If you are writing this code line in the M file, then no need to click on this run button, because clicking on the run button will again start from the first line up to the last line, due to which it will start training again. Therefore, in this case, just select the last line, then click on the function key on your keyboard and hold it, and then press F9. This will run only the selected line. Alternatively, you can write this line in the command window and press enter. It will provide you the ANN testing output. Now let me explain this code line. In this line, Y means output, which is equal to the SimNet. This means simulate the trained artificial neural network. Here we are giving three input values for three input variables, namely A, B and C. Suppose we want to test the output of the ANN at the input of 0.5 for all three input variables. Therefore, here 0.5 is written three times. Now press enter. It can be noticed that ANN has provided the output to be 5. Let's check it again whether it is right or not. As we already know the equation, therefore, put the input value A, B and C as 0.5 in the equation and calculate the output Y. You can see the output is 5. Friends, are you surprised how ANN has successfully provided you the correct output without knowing the exact mathematical equation? Let's test it again for some other value. Suppose this time we want to test the ANN result at the input of 1 for A, B and C. For this purpose, just replace 0.5 with 1 for all three inputs and press enter. You can see the ANN has provided the output of 9.999 for these inputs. Let's check it again whether it is correct or not. Put these values in the equation and by calculating the output, it may be noted that the actual answer is 10. Therefore, the ANN result is almost similar to the 10. Friends, what are you thinking? Is it a magic that ANN is giving the correct answer without knowing the mathematical equation? No, it's not a magic. In fact, it is a purely mathematical training of the ANN using the different iterative algorithms due to which ANN becomes able to find the correct output. Friends, at this stage, I want to ask again, is there any limitation of the ANN? The answer to this question is that, yes, there exists some limitation of the ANN too. It may be noted that the ANN testing totally depends upon the input and output data. If we want to test the ANN for those data which are not used in the training of the ANN, then ANN may provide wrong results. It is because in the training of the ANN, no such data was involved. Let me show you here. In our example, we have trained the ANN for the minimum and maximum input values of A, B and C from 0 to 1. It means that ANN will provide the correct results when inputs are used within this range. But what will happen when I use the input values of A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20 and C is equal to 25? Can you guess what will happen? What will be the result of the ANN? What's your opinion? ANN will provide the correct result or wrong result? The simple answer to this question is that ANN will not provide the correct answer. Why? Because these input ranges are not used in the ANN training. Let's test it. Put the value of A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20 and C is equal to 25 and press enter. You can see the ANN provides the result of 22.224. Friends, depending upon your computer, ANN may provide different answer. Now compare this answer with the mathematical equation answer. You can see the correct answer is 205. Now you may be surprised to see that ANN answer is very far away from the correct answer. However, no need to be surprised. It is because ANN has not gone through the training process of these input variables. If you want to get the correct answer, then increase the input and output data range from 0 to 25. and then train the ANN. After the successful training, ANN will provide you the accurate results. Therefore, now you become clear that ANN totally depends upon the data. Larger the data, larger will be the accuracy. On the other hand, larger data will take lot of time to train the ANN. Therefore, we have to keep all these points in mind while training the ANN for a particular case. However, to be on the safe side, we must include the maximum and minimum input range for the particular problem for the training. Otherwise, the results may be not accurate. Now, question may arise that how to know the minimum and maximum range of the data for a particular case. Friends, it's very easy. Suppose we want to use the ANN for voltage control. Then we know that in per unit, the voltage always have the minimum value of 0 and maximum value to 1. In certain cases, the maximum voltage in per unit is taken as 1.1. Therefore, for best ANN training, we must include the voltage range from 0 to 1.1 or 1.2. Similarly, if we want to control the frequency of the power system, then we know that minimum and maximum frequency range is from 0 to 50 Hz or 60 Hz. Therefore, for best training of ANN, we may include the input data from 0 to 50 or 60 or even 70. Similarly, if we want to control the speed of the induction motor or turbine, we know that the speed has the input range from 0 to 3000 RPM or 3600 RPM. Therefore, for best training, we may consider the speed data from 0 to 3000 RPM or 3600 RPM or even little bit higher for better results. Friends, by this way, the minimum and maximum input data for a particular case can be obtained for the ANN training. Friends, in this video, I have discussed how to implement the ANN in MATLAB through programming. For this purpose, I have taken the mathematical example. At the first stage, we obtained the input and output data for its training. After that, we trained the artificial neural network using Leuenberg-Marquardt algorithm. After the successful training, we tested the ANN for various inputs in order to test its performance. Friends, our main target is how to implement the ANN for an engineering problem, especially power system problem. But obviously, before coming to this stage, still we need to learn many basic points that are necessary for the ANN implementation in engineering problem. That's why I have started from the mathematical example. In the next video, I will discuss how to shift this trained ANN into Simulink and test its performance, as well as how to train the ANN through GUI tool, which is very simple and easy to use. Therefore, stay connected with me for this interesting learning, because this ANN can be used for undergraduate final year project, master research, as well as PhD research for any engineering field, as well as medical and other related fields. That's all for today's tutorial. I hope you really enjoyed this tutorial. Friends, I upload many videos based on various topics of power system and motivation on regular basis. Therefore, don't forget to subscribe my channel in order not to miss my latest videos. And don't forget to share my videos with your friends and class fellows so that they can also get benefit from these videos. Thank you very much.